الله أكبر الطيران الحربي الله أكبر
يلا. It's no longer possible to work in Syria in areas controlled by the Islamic State group. After last year's abduction of MSF personnel by members of armed groups, the organization no longer had the guarantees required to ensure the security of its teams. So in August 2014, MSF decided to pull out its international staff and cut back its operations, which are now run from Turkey.
It's particularly frustrating, I think, for us now, because we no longer have international staff inside Syria. So it's the impression that I get is all secondhand information from our national staff working inside. And what they're telling me and what they told me during the last few months was that it's a real disaster inside. Allahu
Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Due to the absence of guarantees regarding its team's security, MSF had to close several facilities, including a hospital under Islamic State control in Aleppo Governorate. But needs here are huge.
Bon, on a une situation qui ne fait que s'aggraver parce que
after almost 4 years of war, the fighting continues and the situation in Syria is getting worse. Government forces continue to target health facilities. The health system has completely collapsed and people suffering from chronic diseases are being denied regular access to treatment.
Ne peuvent plus se faire suivre de manière régulière.
The conflict has led to large numbers of people with burn injuries. Children and adults with severe burns arrive every day at the MSF hospital, which is still open in Idlib province. It's the only centre in North Syria providing this kind of specialist treatment. Between May 2014 and April 2015, the teams admitted close to 1,700 burn victims to the emergency room.
We provide burn patients with adapted surgical treatment, skin grafts, for example, and physiotherapy. Because burns can lead to contracture, it's crucial to mobilize the limbs.
The burns are caused by explosions and domestic accidents, as people here cook and keep themselves warm with poor quality fuel.
In one camp, there was a fire that then set fire to a whole group of tents. It happened early in the morning, and there were children sleeping in those tents. It's not their fault. People are getting burned because they're trying to keep warm, or because of barrel bombs exploding.
Beyond the camp, the violence continues, causing more and more Syrians to flee. Since the conflict began 4 years ago, half of Syria's population have had to leave their homes. Those who haven't left the country are in camps near the border, like this one in the north.
There are 300 families here. We were given 60 tents during a first distribution, then a further 30, so 90 in all. People sold their furniture and whatever belongings they brought with them to buy a tent or build some form of shelter.
Living conditions for these families are difficult, particularly during the winter months when it's cold and it snows. To mitigate the disastrous consequences of the collapse of the health system, MSF has carried out several vaccination campaigns. However, needs in general are enormous. People are desperate for more assistance, but much to MSF's regret, delivering aid is proving difficult due to the lack of security.